Next is a class on the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Adyalila, Volume 1, Chapter 1, Text Number 10, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 3, 1975, in Mayapur, India.
I offer my full obeisances under the feet of Sri Nityananda Ram, a partial part of whom is Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. From the navel of Garbhodakshaya Vishnu sprouts the lotus that is the birthplace of Brahma, the engineer of the universe. The stem of that lotus is the resting place of the multitude of planets.
Jasya angsangsang Jasya angsangsa Silagat bhodakshayi Jannabhi abjam lokasangato nalam लोकश्रष्टु श्रुतिका धाम धातु तं श्री नित्यानंद रामं प्रपद्ये. यू हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड कारणोदक्षाई इज द प्लेनरी पोर्शन ऑफ संकर्षण. नाउ फ्रॉम कारणोदक्षाई इज गर्भोदक्षाई. Garbhodakshai means this within the womb or bottom of this universe there is a ocean, big ocean. And in that ocean the plenary portion of Karanadakshai Vishnu enters. This is explained in the Bhagavad Gita, Vishtavya Aham Idam Krishnam Ekangshina Sthito Jagat. By one portion, the Karanadakshai Vishnu enters each universe, and within that universe, he creates a ocean by his perspiration. Now, there are so many questions. How these oceans are created? The scientists say that it is a combination of hydrogen and oxygen gas. So where from this gas came? The answer is here. Of course, from the gas, water comes out. If you cover on boiling pot the gas, the vapor coming, and you will find spots of water. So from the gas, the water comes. And from the water gas comes. This is nature's way. But the original water came from the perspiration of this Garbhodakshai Vishnu. Just like you have got perspiration, you can produce, say, 1 gram or say 1 ounce of water through your bodily heat. That you have got practical experience. So if you can produce 1 ounce of water from your body, why God cannot produce volumes and millions of tons of water from His body? Where is the difficulty to understand? You are a teeny soul, and you have got a small body, you can produce 1 ounce of water by your perspiration. Why God, who has got the gigantic body, He cannot produce water, the Garbhodakshai, Garbhodak water? There is no reason to disbelieve. This is called Achinta Shakti, inconceivable power. unless you accept inconceivable power of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, there is no meaning of God. If you think a person means like me or you, yes, like me or you, God is also person. That is accepted in the Vedas. Nitya nityanam, chetanas chetananam. There are many chetanas, living entities, and they are all eternal. They are many, plural number. Nitya nityanam, chetanas chetananam. But there is another nitya. Nitya nityana, two. One is singular number and one is plural number. What is the distinction? The distinction is eko jo bahunam vidadati kama. That singular number is particularly so powerful that he is supplying the necessities of all the plural number. The plural number are the living entities, anantaya kalpate. Then you cannot count how many living entities are there. But they are to be maintained by the singular number. That is the distinction. God is person, you are also person, I am also person. We exist eternally, as it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Krishna said to Arjuna that you, me, all the soldiers and kings who have assembled there, it is not that they did not exist in the past. They are existing at present and they will continue to exist in that way in the future. That is called Nityanam, Chetananam. So this is the process of creation. That the garbhodakshai, karanadakshai Vishnu, from his breathing, he created from the breathing, from the pores of the body, he created innumerable universes, and in each and every universe he entered again. And entering there, he produced a lotus flower. Within the stem of that lotus flower, there are so many planets. Just see the gigantic lotus stem. These are to be known from the Shastra. You cannot imagine how the creation takes place. Huge creation. That's sort of explanation, there was a chunk and it exploded. No, these are not explanations. Here is explanation. In the Shastra, Shastra Chakshusha, you have to see by your Shastric eyes, not your limited speculative eyes. That will not help us. Such gigantic business. You are a teeny soul, your brain is very small. You cannot imagine the process of creation by your sporadic thoughts. That is not possible. So the creation means, the first of all, the universes are created through the breathing period of Karan's Udakshai Vishnu, then each and every universe he enters as Garbhodakshai Vishnu, and he creates half of the universe is filled up with water. The water came from his perspiration, and then he lies down there, then he creates the lotus flower, and upon the lotus flower Brahma is first born. This is Krishna. That Brahma means not an uncivilized human being, the most intelligent person, first creation. We cannot accept the rubbish theory of Darwin that there was no human being. That is his theory, that is not fact. He admits also that I have made this by speculation. He has admitted. Our Dr. Swarup Damodar has quoted from his letter to a friend. He admits that he simply speculated. He has no factual knowledge. So you cannot understand the method of creation by your teeny brain speculation. You give up this idea. This is not possible at all. You take knowledge from the Shastra, from the person who is perfect in knowledge. We have got knowledge, you have got knowledge. Somebody has got more knowledge than me, than you. But Krishna says, matta parataram nanyat kinchij asti dhananjaya. You cannot find out a person who has got more knowledge than Krishna. And God means one who has got full knowledge. Vaisajyasya samagrasya bijyasya jasasya sriya jnana jnana vairagyasya iva sarayiti bhagangana. So, Krishna has got full knowledge and Krishna's expansion has got full knowledge. So we have to receive knowledge. The same thing is supported in the Bhagavad Gita. Athabha bahunaitena kinyatena tabharjana vishtyabhya aham idam krishnam ekangshena sthitu jagat. This whole material creation is existing in one part of his energy. That is also confirmed in the Brahma Sangha. Ekappasaurachayatam jagadanna koti. One part of his energy just to create the whole universes, the material world. Ekappasaurachayatam jagadanna koti. Annantarastham paramanachayantarastham. He does not enter only within the universe, andantarastham, but he enters within the atom. Paramanachayantarastham. Govindamadipurisam tamangam. Jachakti rasti jagadannachayajadantam. Jachakti, whose energy is there within the universe. And ananta, that is, their universes are ananta, unlimited. That is creation. You cannot conceive of the creation by your this teeny brain. That is not possible. That is Dr. Frog's philosophy. He is contemplating about the Atlantic Ocean, living in a 3 feet well. That is not possible. So, this is the process of lokasrastu sutika dhama dhatu. Dhatu, dhatu means one who creates. So, Brahma is the secondary creator. Krishna or Vishnu, he creates the situation. Then, he gives him a seat, that lotus flower-like. And when he was puzzled in the beginning, everything was dark. He could not understand where from I am coming, what is my duty, why I am sitting here. When he was puzzled, then from within there was dictation that you meditate. Tapa. You undergo austerities. Then you will gradually understand. So even Brahma, the first creature of this creation, he had to meditate. Why I am here? And what is the purpose of my coming? So we are also this in the same position. We are the the dynastic expansion of Brahma. Brahma's son is Manu, or the sun god Manushya. Manushya means coming from Manu. Therefore we are called Manushya. So the same process. We are born ignorant. Born ignorant. Human life is a chance to dissipate this ignorance. And that requires tapasya. Not to live like cats and dogs, frivolous life. That will not help us. Tapa. Tapo dibbam jina putraka suddheta satta. That human life is meant for tapasya, austerities. Not to live extravagant life, irresponsible life, like cats and dogs. No, that is not human life. That is animal life. So therefore Shastra says that you undergo austerities, then your existence will be purified. And then pure knowledge you will get and you will understand what is your position, why you are in this material world, why you are suffering the threefold miseries, why you are obliged to die, why you are obliged to become old man. So many things you have to learn. But if we learn like cats and dogs, then we spoil our life. As Brahma, the first created being, had to undergo tapasya to get information from the Supreme. The Supreme Lord is within you. He is there. But He will advise when you are fixed up by tapasya, determined with bhav, then He will talk to you. He is ready to talk, but you require to acquire the qualification to hear him. And what is that qualification? This Krishna consciousness, devotional service. As it is said in the Bhagavad Gita, tesam satatu yuktana bhajatam priti purvagam. Such persons, don't we? Tesaṁ satata yuktāna. Satata means always, 24 hours. Not that 5 minutes I meditate and rest of the time I live like cats and dogs. No. This kind of meditation will not help you. Krishna says satata. Satata means 24 hours. You have to mold your life in such a way that 24 hours you will think of Krishna. This is Krishna consciousness. If you think that I have chanted my 16 rounds, now I have finished my business, now I can do whatever nonsense I like. No. Krishna says no. Sadata. Therefore we have to plan our life in such a way that we haven't got any other engagement than service of Krishna. This is required. Tisam satata yuktana. Satata means 24 hours. Yukta means engaged. What for? What is that engagement? Bhajatam. Bhajatam, bhaja, sivayam. To serve Krishna. bhajatang, how? Priti purvakam. Not that, oh, Krishna has said, all right, let me do. No, with love and affection. Then you will get attachment. Unless you develop love for Krishna, you cannot be engaged 24 hours. That is not possible. Therefore it is said, priti purvakam. Not officially, but with love. If you acquire this qualification, then you will talk with Krishna who is within your heart. He will give you instruction so that you can get rid of this hellish condition of life and go back to home and back to Godhead. Thank you very much.